Amazing.
All right.
That's what DJs are doing now. Wow.
Yeah.
Like I say, the technology is somewhat similar because in the Congress thing here, it's almost similar to having a machine there.
It is. I mean, you have a lot of elements, and like I was saying earlier when we was talking, you know, nowadays, I'm looking at the technology. Nowadays, DJs don't have to come with a whole lot of records and things like that, and they can just find sounds and things like that. But for me, it's always organic, going and looking and finding vinyl and stuff like that. So I like going to mom and pop stores. And, you know, now they, you know, something that you would usually see in a keyboard, and, you know, it's absolutely all in this little box right here, and it all sounds big, you know? Yeah, all the sounds sound killing, you know? Crazy, you know, so.
Oh, nice.
You know, so many things, you know, with that, and it gives me a lot of options, because when I'm hearing a lot of things that I would like to add towards, you know, whatever element that I'm in, project, like delays, effects, and things like that, I could do that. And just like the same thing with you, what you have with your pedal, the MIDI and everything, working back and forth with the, true, you know. So.
That was one of my favorite guitar sounds. Yeah, you mess around, put my favorite guitar player out of business doing that. You know, another thing is, I noticed that you started really young, like you were like 14. And,
young tyke. I was just 14 and grew up in the Bronx, and, you know, I had a lot of musical influences, you know, around me in my neighborhood, you know, starting off listening to hip hop and soul and Caribbean music and Latin music. And I don't know, I just became a music lover just from just being in my area. You know, I had all these eclectic things going on, and one thing led to another, and you know, all the arts and the culture, you know, I just kind of took to all of that. And when I had a musician friend who played drums, Rich Harrison, you know, he just kind of turned me on to a lot of things, you know, and started playing with him and his band, which was I&I, and that was an alternative rock band. And then from that, I went to Medeski Martin Wood, you know, and then they kind of took me on with, as a fourth member, and doing the, that's how I got into the whole jam band scene, you know.
That's great.
And seeing how, you know, all the, it was nothing really going on like that at the time, and it was hip, you know, keyboards, bass, drums, and a DJ, and we were basically performing in front of all these young kids, and they just absorbed it well, and it was great. It was good to see and also be a part of that whole scene musically, and working with some of the other bands and the whole jam band scene and hip hop scene as well. And then also started my band Project Logic. And we did a couple records on Rope It Up and Project Logic at Live at Wetlands, which had a lot of special guests, you know. And the first record, DJ Logic Presents Project Logic, which started off with Melvin Gibbs and Scooter Warner and some of the guys from MW and some other good friends from the whole downtown scene that I came up with. And took off and did Anomaly, and you know, the rest is all good. And also, you know, just from all of that, you know, it was like a learning process and seeing me grow. So, you know, and that looks, it feels good just listening back to some of all that stuff that I created, doing the stuff that I'm doing now, you know, working with like John Popper and doing that, the Popper Project, you know, harmonica, drums, turntable and bass, and you know those elements. And when you come in, you know, you also come in and add the flavors as well. Oh, so that's that. that's always special, you know.
Some of my best shows I've had playing with you.
That's right.
New Year's Eve here recently.
That's right. Great, and you know, that was special, you know, to be able to play with Bernie Worrell, you know, Leo Nocentelli, you know, Pooji, all those guys. These are guys that, you know, I grew up listening to their records and having the honor to be up there rocking it with them, and you know, not giving direction, but just vibing. Everything, yeah, just everybody was all filled, and you know, and it just, everything spoke for itself, and people had a good time. So,
well, you said the right key to everything is listening, right. And I guess that's kind of gives you advantage as a DJ because you really listen. Mm-hmm. And, like, even with me on stage, I'm really like, listening to everybody else. Like John Popper, he's one of my favorite people to be next to and watch play. It's just something about him that's just kindred spirit to me. He's I really like seeing him do his thing.
Yeah, it's awesome.
And so you think spin us another groove right quick and we'll get out of here.
You know, I just try to find records with cool breaks and grooves and things like that. So basically just to set up, you know, whoever I'm playing with, or sometimes, you know, either I'll lay down a beat to set up the groove, or I just have the drummer or the bass player to start off something, you know, and just have fun. Let's see, I'm trying to find the right groove to lead us out of here.